actor Maxine given Glamour award by Hollywood crowd, gets brutal surprise from voters. Maxine Waters was given the Lifetime Achievement Glamour Award by the idiots in Hollywood who introduced her as a warrior for truth, fighting the dark forces in America. That's how disconnected the Hollywood crowd is, they have no idea that back in anti-Maxine's district, her constituents are suffering from crime and poverty. But, don't worry, Maxine just got a brutal surprise from voters who know all about her corruption. Mad Maxine continues to be the new fresh face for the Democratic Party at 79 years old. Since Hillary Clinton lost the election, the Hollywood crowd has adopted Waters as their new pet. Even so, it was really rather ridiculous to give Maxine Waters a Glamour Award for Lifetime Achievement. "I feel so very special," Waters declared after accepting her Glamour Award from Zendaya, an American actress and singer known for starring as Rocky Blue in the Disney Channel sitcom Shake It Up, who is clad in a hot pink Victor and Rolf jumpsuit, reports The Hollywood Reporter. "I am so pleased to see the concern that you are showing about what is happening at the highest level of government," Maxine added. The Hollywood Reporter adds that Maxine went on to address young people in a thunderous tone that straddled the line between motivational speaker and preacher, as she roared, "You recognize when a leader is dangerous, even if that leader is the President of the United States of America." Maxine continued, "I want you to know that you can stand up to him or anybody else." And I continued to say, "Impeach him." Before exiting the stage, she led the crowd in a rousing chant of "Impeach 45, fist raised to the ceiling." What does that mean, getting a Lifetime Achievement Award from Glamour magazine? Has Andy Maxine devoted her life to glamour? Well, she has devoted her life to corruption to enrich herself with taxpayer dollars, and I guess that constitutes living a glamorous life in Hollywood. Just south of Hollywood is District 43, Maxine's district. But, you will not catch any of the rich and famous in that part of Los Angeles. In fact, Auntie Maxine won't even live there. She's living the glamorous life in Hancock Park in a mansion with a wall to keep out the riffraff. When she got back from the Glamour Awards, a brutal surprise was waiting for her. Maxine has never really been challenged to be re-elected, holding that congressional seat for over 30 years. She must have realized that GOP challenger for her seat is not only serious, but he has some heavyweights behind him. This caused poor crazy Maxine to stop her Impeach 45 screaming as she launched into her latest conspiracy theory. Now at Maxine Waters is blaming Trump and Russia for colluding against her 2018 re-election campaign, and calling me a Hispanic American, a white supremacist, tweeted Omar Navarro, her GOP challenger. Maxine tweeted, "Trump has sent his friends to LA to run a smear campaign against #MaxWaters in 2018. His allies below are backing my #altright opponent. We need your help. Join our movement today." Waters shows a photo of Roger Stone, Steve Bannon, Sheriff Joe Arpaio, and President Donald Trump, all of whom are actively campaigning for Navarro, making Auntie Maxine go nuts. She is feeling the heat of a real challenger who has a really good chance to take away her political power and her taxpayer slush fund. Omar countered the crazed congresswoman by saying, "Maxine Waters, the only reclaiming that will happen in 2018 will be when I #reclaim my time as congressman of the 43rd congressional district." There is something so refreshing about Navarro, who grew up in Mad Maxine's crime-ridden district and can bash her endlessly as one of her constituents. Maxine did not get the memo that Navarro is the son of Mexican Americans who came here legally and ended up living in Waters' 43rd district. Calling him a white supremacist is laughable and proves she will call everyone a racist who does not share her politics. Omar is calling for debates, but so far, Maxine is dodging those requests. He has been going door to door in the community and showing up at city council meetings, where he is making his platform known. His platform is exactly what Donald Trump ran on, and Mad Maxine is just realizing that she is in for a real fight this time. It's time to drain Maxine Waters from the swamp, and it looks like she has met her match in the 2018 election.